Yeah.
Good afternoon to all participants. On behalf of Sitara, I welcome you to day 30 of the Appendix 3 session. Today, the topic assigned is financial appraisal, railway projects under DCF technique. To take you through the topic, we are privileged to have C.K. Damodar Prasad Garu, faculty Griffith. Good afternoon, sir, and welcome to the session. Now, over to the topic.
Thank you. Thank you, Manigaru. Dear participants, good afternoon to all of you. This is one of the important topics from our learning point of view, and not only learning point of view, but from the point of view of Appendix 3A examination. Normally, the question will be like this. Please discuss about what is financial justification. What are the points to be seen in a proposal for a lane capacity work? Vaisa questions hamara appendix 3A mein pucha jayega. So we should be ready to write such important topics, because this will be dealt at very few places in finance section. So therefore, if we knew certain important points, we will be in a position to attempt this particular question. I request the participants to please go through after my session. Please go through Finance Code Chapter 2. थोड़ा पहले पढ़ने में थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम हो जाएगी, बट लेटर ऑन आफ्टर माय सेशन इफ यू रीड यू विल ट्राई टू गेन कॉन्फिडेंस एंड अटेम्प्ट दिस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन. सो स्ट्रेट अवे आई विल बी गोइंग टू द टॉपिक फाइनेंशियल अप्राइजल ऑफ द रेलवे प्रोजेक्ट्स अंडर डीसीएफ टेक्निक. एक्चुअली हमारे को पता है कि ये डीसीएफ प्रोजेक्ट फाइनेंशियल अप्राइजल क्यों होना चाहिए, व्हाई शुड वी हैव द प्रोजेक्ट अप्राइजल एंड व्हाट आर द इंग्रेडिएंट्स दैट वी विल बी हैविंग, व्हाट इज द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ दिस डीसीएफ टेक्निक व्हिच नॉर्मली अडॉप्टेड इन रेलवेज, व्हाई एट ऑल a financial appraisal is required. And one more point which in examinations normally what it is asked is, what is financial justification and what are the areas where financial justification is not required? That also sometimes they will ask. And third point will be ABC. Yes, third point will be what are the points you will be looking when a proposal received for a land capacity work. So this is how my entire topic is developed on this particular aspect. So please listen carefully, and at the end of the session, जो भी doubts है हमें clear करेगा. A financial justification, whenever a particular project इन्वेस्टमेंट डिसीशंस हमें लेते हैं टू गेट दोज प्रोजेक्ट्स और प्रपोजल्स इंक्लूडेड इन द पिंक बुक, दोज आइटम्स दे आर टू बी फाइनेंशियली जस्टिफाइड. तो कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट माने तो इट इज नॉट द कैपिटल, इट इज द कैपिटल नेचर ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट जो भी है, वो डिसीशंस वो प्रपोजल्स जो भी हमारे को फाइनेंस कंकरेंस के वास्ते आते हैं, दोज आइटम्स वी हैव टू स्क्रूटनाइज वेरी केयरफुली, बिकॉज एनी कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट इट इज इफ इट इज यील्डिंग गुड रिजल्ट इट इज फाइन, इफ इट इज नॉट यील्डिंग इट विल बी ए संक कॉस्ट, वो तो डूबा हो जाएगा, पूरा मनी it will go waste. So as a finance officer, in any proposal which is requiring capital investment means capital DRF DF jo bhi hai investment, that should be financially justified. Ye, for this there are certain exceptions. I will let you know now itself. Okay, so that is most important. So financially agar jo bhi project viable justified nahi hai, and we will say that it is not financially viable. From our verbatim comments hame likhte hain financially not viable. So when it is done, again the board will think of it and whether to include or not include. वो बहुत सारे इवेल्युएशन टेक्निक्स है, वो भी हम बताएंगे. सो इतना आप ही इतना जानकारी कीजिएगा, जो भी कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट का प्रपोजल आएगा वो फाइनेंशियली जस्टिफाइड होना चाहिए. ये फाइनेंशियली जस्टिफाइड माने तो क्या होता है माने तो अर्निंग्स, जो भी प्रपोजल से अर्निंग्स आते हैं, जो भी एक्सपेंसेस होते हैं, ये अर्निंग्स ज्यादा हुआ तो हम कहलाते हैं दैट इज कॉल्ड नेट फाइनेंशियल गेन. एक प्रोजेक्ट कंस्ट्रक्ट करने में थोड़ा एक्सपेंडिचर तो लग जाएगा, तो दैट एक्सपेंडिचर एंड फ्रॉम दैट प्रोजेक्ट इफ यू गेट सम अर्निंग्स माने अर्निंग्स इंक्रीज इन अर्निंग्स भी हो सकता है और रिडक्शन इन एक्सपेंडिचर वो भी हो सकता है, और बोथ उसमें लगा होगा. तो एदर दैट फाइनेंशियल नेट गेन वॉट एवर वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग दैट इज फाइनेंशियली जस्टिफाइड, माने तो नेट फाइनेंशियल गेन होना चाहिए. हमें जितना खर्च करे वो खर्च करने के बाद उसके ऊपर हमारे को अर्निंग्स आते हैं तो वी कॉल इट एज नेट फाइनेंशियल गेन. अगर हमें खर्च ज्यादा किया और अर्निंग्स वो प्रोजेक्ट से बहुत कम आ रहे, तो देन वी कैन से इट इज नॉट फाइनेंशियली जस्टिफाइड. सो दिस इज हाउ वी हैव टू नो दिस टर्मिनोलॉजी, दैट इज व्हाट इज मेंट बाय फाइनेंशियल जस्टिफिकेशन. फाइनेंशियल देयर शुड बी नेट फाइनेंशियल गेन, दैट मीन्स अर्निंग्स माइनस वर्किंग एक्सपेंसेस शुड बी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एदर इंक्रीज इन द अर्निंग्स और रिडक्शन इन द एक्सपेंडिचर और बोथ. वैसा है तो देन इट इज वी कैन से दैट देर इज ए नेट फाइनेंशियल गेन. एक्चुअली हमारे को बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस हमारा मन में आ जाएगा कि सर कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट माने तो खाली कैपिटल का प्रपोजल्स फाइनेंस जस्टिफाई करना, और कहीं दूसरा प्रपोजल्स भी फाइनेंशियली जस्टिफाई होना चाहिए. सो फॉर दैट देर इज आंसर इन अवर फाइनेंस कोड इटसेल्फ दैट इट सेज दैट except when renewal or replacement is inevitable, the expenditure chargeable to the DRF should be financially justified in the same way as any other expenditure of capital nature. Capital nature mane pure ka pura kaisa DCF technique or whatever finance justification is required to be given to accounts department, similar way DRF jo bhi project DRF ko चार्ज होते हैं, those proposals are also should be financially justified. But उसको ये DRF के वास्ते थोड़ा एक्सेप्शन है. वो क्या है? When renewal and replacement are inevitable. अगर inevitable ये करना ही पड़ता है, then in that case we need not seek financial justification in case of DRF. Otherwise it should even any project if it is chargeable to DRF it should be financially justified. Inevitable mane to kya hota hai, quarter life ho jayega, then it should be changed, then in such cases we need not ask for financial justification. Otherwise even on DRF also any project if it is to be charged to DRF then it should be financially justified, just like any other proposal which is like in the nature of capital. Then one more point is interest and depreciation. These are considered in the orthodox methods. A orthodox method kya hota hai, main bolunga, but not in the discounted cash flow methods of financial evaluation of the project. Now, interest and depreciation, these are considered in the orthodox methods, but these are not to be considered. Even when I say depreciation, even inflation also, we should not consider in discounted cash flow method if we want to evaluate a project, financial evaluation, if we are doing for a particular project, then these two elements we will not consider. डिस्काउंटेड कैश फ्लो ये शब्द को ऊपर थोड़ा जानकारी हमें लेना है. कैश फ्लो मीन्स कैश इज कमिंग और कैश फ्लो मीन्स कैश आउटगोइंग. कैश इनफ्लो आ रहे हैं, देन वी कॉल इट एज ए इनकम और अर्निंग. कैश आउटफ्लो, कैश जा रहे हैं, दैट मीन्स ए एक्सपेंडिचर होते हैं. ये DCF टेक्निक में, ये कैश फ्लो टेक्निक में वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इज दैट इट विल बी कॉल्ड एज कैश फ्लो ओनली, वी विल नॉट कॉल देम एज अर्निंग्स और एक्सपेंडिचर. एक्सपेंडिचर एंड अर्निंग्स ये शब्द हमें नहीं इस्तेमाल करते हैं. वी विल नॉट यूज देम इन वेन एवर आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट डिस्काउंटेड कैश फ्लो टेक्निक इन द फाइनेंशियल इवेल्युएशन ऑफ ए प्रोजेक्ट. क्योंकि दिस कैश फ्लो, कैश इनफ्लो माने कैश इज कमिंग इन, इट इज अर्निंग एज आई सेड, एंड कैश आउटफ्लो. एंड व्हेन आई वांट टू से बोथ आई विल यूज द टर्म कैश फ्लो. कैश फ्लो माने यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट बोथ अर्निंग्स एंड एक्सपेंडिचर. ये थोड़ा जानकारी आप होना चाहिए. एंड वन मोर पॉइंट इज cash flow, when I am using the word cash flow, that is why this depreciation and interest, which are in the nature of adjustment, normally you should not be considered. So the rationale behind why depreciation is not considered in the DCF cash flow technique means it is an adjustment. हमारा bookkeeping में भी हम पढ़ाया होगा. So adjustment entry है, तो इसीलिए वहां पर cash flow नहीं रहता. That is, either inflow will not be there or outflow will not be there. So that is why they are not to be considered. So discounted cash flow method in the financial projects may interest and depreciation will not be considering. अच्छा, और एक 5 mark का question भी दे सकते हैं. Now what are the areas where no financial justification is required? ये तो exception है. ये exception आप यहाँ पर DRF में मैं दिया. तो when except on renewal and replacements are inevitable, for DRF also financial justification is required. That is one. And one more exception is here, no financial justification generally will not be asked on these items. What are they? Number one, statutory obligation. Jo bhi by statute hame karna hai wo hum kar rahe hai, then in that case no financial justification will be asked. Then पूरे बाकी के आइटम्स आप देख लीजिएगा. वो बाकी का 3 आइटम्स, सेफ्टी वर्क्स, पैसेंजर एमिनिटी वर्क्स एंड लेबर वेलफेयर वर्क्स, ये तीनों क्या कहाँ से आते हैं? DF से आते हैं. सो DF वर्क्स वी विल नॉट आस्क फॉर फाइनेंशियल जस्टिफिकेशन. इतना जानकारी ये मन में रख दीजिएगा, व्हाट इज फाइनेंशियल जस्टिफिकेशन एंड अंडर दिस वे नो फाइनेंशियल जस्टिफिकेशन विल बी इंसिस्टेड इन रेलवे. ये थोड़ा जानकारी अभी हो चुके हैं. नाउ आई विल गो टू फर्दर. फाइनेंशियल जस्टिफिकेशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड मस्ट. कहाँ कहाँ ये वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट है? तो आई सेड एक्सेप्शन आई हैव गिवन एंड आई एम इलाबोरेटिंग. हमारे को जो पहचान है वो पहचान के बोल में मैं आपको थोड़ा और अधिक जानकारी मैं दे रहा हूँ. मस्ट कहाँ पर है? न्यू लाइन्स, लाइन कैपेसिटी वर्क्स माने गेज कन्वर्शन, डबलिंग, लूप बढ़ाना, लूप एडिशनल प्रोवाइड करना, वैसा बहुत सारे चीज हैं. वो पूरा लाइन कैपेसिटी वर्क्स. लाइन कैपेसिटी वर्क माने वो लाइन का कैपेसिटी बढ़ाना. वैसा जो भी काम करते हैं और एक क्रॉसिंग स्टेशन बनाना वैसा वो डोज आर टू बी फाइनेंशियली जस्टिफाइड एंड एड रिमॉडलिंग दट एंड टर्मिनल फैसिलिटीज वो भी करना है तो फाइनेंशियल जस्टिफिकेशन जरूरी है. वर्कशॉप्स एमएनपी आइटम्स आरएसपी आइटम्स ये पूरे का पूरा फाइनेंशियल जस्टिफिकेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड. इससे पहले मैं बोलता था आपको एक ये प्रोजेक्ट्स इवेल्युएशन करने में बहुत सारे क्राइटेरिया होते हैं मगर हमारा रेलवे में खाली दो दो तरीके का बिकॉज ऑफ आवर नेचर ऑफ आवर डिपार्टमेंट विच इज सेट टू बी डिपार्टमेंटल एंटरप्राइज. तो इसीलिए हमें अकाउंटिंग के बारे में वैसा दो तरीके हमें अकाउंट्स कमर्शियल अकाउंट्स एंड गवर्नमेंट अकाउंट्स हमें कैसा बनाते हैं वैसे ही इवन प्रोजेक्ट इवेल्युएशन में भी थोड़ा परिवर्तन है हमारा रेलवे प्रोजेक्ट्स का फाइनेंशियल इवेल्युएशन में. वो क्या 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 है बोले तो इनटेंजिबल बेनिफिट्स सच एज सोशल बेनिफिट्स एनवायरमेंटल बेनिफिट्स है इकोनॉमिकल बेनिफिट्स है. These are the essential criteria for social projects like infrastructure project for upliftment of weaker sections. ये weaker sections के बारे में government जो भी initiatives लेते हैं social benefit, environmental benefit, economical benefit. So social benefit माने तो जो भी backward areas are there. So suppose we want to put a line. Then we will not see financial justification. There is something else we will see. I will tell you later on. Similarly, environmental benefits. Coal ka problem hote hai. Nahi to diesel ka problem hota hai environment ko. Agar electrification se environmental ko benefits bahut zyada hai. Then even though such projects, if they are not financially justified. Then और दूसरा तरीके में हमें देखना चाहिए. Evaluation of project should be done at separate level. So these are intangible benefits और economical benefits. अब हमारा financially benefit नहीं है मगर government का GDP बढ़ाने के वास्ते ये जरूरी है. Then in that case, then for that also these are the areas which we will be considering for the infrastructure projects for the upliftment of weaker sections. In case of major projects, hamara railway ke bare mein sochte to then new line constructions, change of traction, just like I said, steam to diesel, diesel to electrification. So such benefits are realized by economy as a whole, assessed by there is separate evaluation. My bolena. Criteria hai, that is it will be done on economic evaluation that we there is one wing is there economic advisor to railway board so that wing will take care of that. So that is why sometimes in social service obligations aapne dekha hoga minus return bhi hote hain magar wo pink book mein aa jata hai. You will be surprised why that is coming. So now you will not surprised because it is a social benefit project. So when social benefit project is there, then we will not go into that because that will be justified on economic basis. So economic evaluation ke basis, it will be included in the big book. So this much jankari aapko further topic lene ke time pe ye itna jankari aapko hona chahiye. Agar और दूसरा तरीका इवेल्युएशन सपोज एज ए सेड सो डिपार्टमेंट एज ए गवर्नमेंट डिपार्टमेंट इकोनॉमिक एडवाइजर देखना अगर गवर्नमेंट इच्छा करे तो वीकर बैकवर्ड एरियाज रीजियंस शुड बी अपलिफ्टेड देन इन दैट केस इकोनॉमिक एडवाइजर इवेल्युएट एंड इफ इट इज इकोनॉमिकली बेनिफिशियल दैट विल बी इंक्लूडेड इन द पिंक बुक. इवन दो again I am repeating, even though it is not financially justified or financially not viable, so that you leave it. नाउ दूसरा तरीके का इवेल्युएशन क्या होते हैं फॉर ए कमर्शियल, बिकॉज हमारे डिपार्टमेंटल एंटरप्राइज, ये कमर्शियल एंटरप्राइज में क्या होते हैं, हमारे को कभी भी किसी कमर्शियल डिपार्टमेंट लीजिएगा वहां पर प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी इज द मोस्ट क्राइटेरिया। अगर जो भी प्रोजेक्ट प्रॉफिटेबल नहीं है उसके ऊपर ध्यान भी नहीं रखते, उसके ऊपर हाथ भी नहीं रखते कमर्शियल डिपार्टमेंट वालों। तो फॉर एनी कमर्शियल प्रोजेक्ट इट शुड बी मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट इज प्रॉफिटेबल, कितना प्रॉफिट दे रहा है। सो एज ए कमर्शियल अंडरटेकिंग नाउ फॉर द रेलवे इट इज इनकम्बेंट टू एंश्योर दैट प्रॉपर फाइनेंशियल रिटर्न इज अर्न्ड ऑन एवरी इन्वेस्टमेंट। सो इट वो जिम्मेदारी दैट इज फॉर अपलिफ्टमेंट ऑफ वीकर सेक्शंस जो भी कर रहे हैं वो इकोनॉमिक इवेल्युएशन के रूप में जस्टिफाई हो जाएगा, इवन दो फाइनेंशियल नॉट गोइंग, बट एज ए कमर्शियल डिपार्टमेंट वी हैव टू एंश्योर दैट ईच एंड एवरी कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट इज फाइनेंशियली जस्टिफाइड। दैट evaluation it has to be done, and whenever you send a proposal to railway board without financial evaluation it will not be checked, even though it is a social benefit project. It should be first checked financially viable or not. So this is very important, so please keep that in mind. Now project evaluation criteria hum maine bataya, abhi project evaluation karne mein techniques kya hote hain, kyunki हमारे पास जो भी कैपिटल है वो बहुत कम होते हैं, हमारे पास पैसे जो बहुत कम अमाउंट रहते हैं क्योंकि बजट सपोर्ट कमी हो जा रहे हैं और इंटरनल रिसोर्सेस कमी हो रहे हैं, एंड मोस्टली वी आर नाउ लार्जली डिपेंडिंग ऑन एक्स्ट्रा बजटरी रिसोर्सेस। तो देन व्हेन अमाउंट इज गेटिंग रिड्यूस्ड there will be so many projects competing for finding a place in the pink book. So ye pink book mein compete karne ke time pe kis project ko choose karna, kis project ko select karna, that will be very very important aspect. So that committing that competing so many projects and the criteria how we will be taking up a particular project, selecting from so many hundreds of projects will be there. So out of them ek project chunna hai, nahi to 10 projects chunna hai, jitna paise hai utne projects chunna hai. So it will be very difficult. Then what should be the criteria, what should be the technique which we have to adopt, that is done by using proper project evaluation techniques. Aur ek fundamental feature ye hai ki any project hame le rahe hain to it is now you should understand that we are committing that so much money we want to put in that project, wo bag mein itna paise hame dalna chahte hain. Not only that, that is okay when you want to put money, that is different issue, but at the same time because our railway is a departmental enterprise, financial return also we will be seeing. Agar financial evaluation nahi hai, social welfare scheme pe hai to wo alag tarike se economic evaluation tarike se hame chunke hamara project pink book mein aa jayega. Magar you should understand that the fundamental feature of a project is that number one, we are committing now to put so much money, 10,000 crore ka money lagana chahte hain, yes, but at the same time we are going to get the benefits in future. Abhi commit ho raha hai hame paise kharch karne ke waste, kyun, why we are committing to get inflow, that is to get benefits from the project in future. Agar future ka very bleak hai or dark hai, then we will not commit any funds on the particular project. So this is the fundamental feature of a project. Agar kahin na puche kya project mane to kya hai, project mane to it is committing current outflow. Outflow माने मैं बोल दिया expenditure, current outflow. अभी पैसा खर्च करने के वास्ते हमें committed है. But at the same time, it should yield a flow of benefit in future. वो चालू होने के बाद पैसे होना चाहिए, पैसे आना चाहिए. Inflow should be there. Otherwise, we cannot call it as a project. It is only expenditure, incurring expenditure. That's all. And this capital, as we knew that it is a scarce and investment. अगर पैसे खर्च कर रहे, वो तो irreversible हो जाएगा. वो पैसे निकालना बहुत मुश्किल हो जाएगा. बाद में पता चला that it is going to be a disaster, but we cannot take our money. So, and there will be so many projects competing for then acceptance. Therefore, financial project appraisal is required. Financial justification is required. So, the methods of project financial appraisal, project appraisal consists of, already I told you that one is financial analysis, another is economic evaluation. A financial evaluation or financial analysis to know whether it is financially justified or not. Economic evaluation, which is done by economic advisor in Bangalore board, it is to see that economically whether it is beneficial to the country or not. So that they will be scrutinizing. But as I said, any project you should have a financial analysis first. Then only economic evaluation. Without financial evaluation, economic evaluation will not be done. ये project evaluation का techniques मैंने बताया. बहुत सारे models होते हैं. ये पूरे models, ये mathematical models. Mathematical माने तो I will not, when I apply this method, I will see mathematical calculations only. And whether it is very important for the railway or very important for the nation, all those things we will not be considering at this point of time. It is only mathematical tool. It is not, suppose some project is very important and justified on social criteria, that will be dealt separately. But this is the model which will tell us whether this financial, a particular project is financially viable or not. Whether it can yield some return on the investment or not. So the our railway code very clearly mentioned about four major models which we employ. There are two models or traditional methods or orthodox methods, or we call them as non-discounted cash flow techniques. वो दो models हैं. और जहाँ पर डिस्काउंटेड कैश फ्लो टेक्निक का मॉडल्स होते हैं वो भी दो है. नाउ लेट अस नो ईच वन. वन इज नॉन डिस्काउंटेड और ऑर्थोडॉक्स ट्रेडिशनल मेथड्स. एक तो पेबैक पीरियड का एक मॉडल है और अकाउंटिंग रेट ऑफ रिटर्न का मॉडल है. अकाउंटिंग रेट ऑफ रिटर्न और रिटर्न ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट और वो आई बोलते हैं. सो दीज आर दी टू मेथड्स विच वी कॉल देम एज ऑर्थोडॉक्स मेथड्स एंड नॉन डिस्काउंट कैश फ्लो मेथड्स. Why we are calling them as orthodox methods, I'll let you know. Then DCF technique ka do models hote hain. DCF discounted cash flow technique ka do models hote hain. Wo kya hai? Net present value model aur internal rate of return model. Net present value mane NPV model and internal rate of return IRR method. These two methods are there in the discounted cash flow techniques. These are discussed in our finance code also, but again I am telling that in our railway any project financial appraisal will be taking up only as under the discounted cash flow technique and under rate of internal rate of return IRR method. Internal rate of return method only we will be employing, but we should know what are the methods that are available and why railway chose only a DCF technique of under internal rate of return technique only why we are employing for our railway projects. We will know now. Okay, even though NPV is there, instead of NPV, even PV is also a discounted cash flow technique only. But we will not employ, we will not take up any project on NPV basis. It is only as per the internal rate of return under DCF technique calculated, that project only will be financially evaluated. So now you understood that it is any project, if you are committing the money and we will be expecting some money to be returned. That is one. And second one is, many projects will be competing for finding a place in the pink book. And one tarika, to know which project to be included and which project to be omitted, there should be a criteria. There should be a technique. So the techniques what we employ is, there are four techniques: orthodox techniques 2 and discounted cash flow techniques 2. But on railway, we will be employing internal rate of return as per DCF technique. That project evaluation technique only will be employing for the inclusion in the PIG book. Okay, now bahut jaldi jaldi I will be telling you about each of the methods. First orthodox methods, then discounted cash flow methods will go. Now under orthodox method, first one is payback period. A payback period mein kya hote hain? It envisages calculation of time during which investment of the project will be recovered. मान लीजिए एक प्रोजेक्ट में मैंने 100 करोड़ आउटफ्लो लगाया. अगर 100 करोड़ में इन हाउ मेनी आई एम नॉट वरीड अबाउट अदर थिंग्स, सो ओनली माय इन्वेस्टमेंट 100 करोड़ इन हाउ मेनी इयर्स आई विल बी गेटिंग बैक. ये पेबैक पीरियड का टाइम है. इन दिस इवैल्यूएशन टेक्निक what I'll be looking at is how quickly, how soon I'll be getting back my money. Jo bhi project bahut jald se jaldi, suppose I decided that within 2 years I should get, or so jo bhi project hai 2 years mein mera paise mujhe ko de diye to wo project select karte hain, hame kaam karte hain. So this is the payback method period. It is very simple to use. And most important point is, वो दो साल के बाद, मगर मैंने लगाया मैनेजमेंट के रूप में, 2 साल में मेरा पैसा आना चाहिए. मेरा पैसा आए तो बस है, बाकी का बाद में क्या होता है वो डिस्ट्रॉय होते हैं, नहीं तो वो बहुत बेहतर होके एंड इट विल बी गिविंग मी मोर एंड मोर रिटर्न्स. आई विल नॉट बी बॉदर्ड. ओनली थिंग इज हाउ क्विकली आई एम गेटिंग. नॉर्मली दिस पे बैक पीरियड will be utilized in a warlike situations, social unrest, vice versa situations where normally any investor would see that how quickly he will get back the money. So once he gets back money, he is not bothered about the project. So that is why it will not take into consideration the profitability of the project, and it will not take that time value of the money. So paise in future jo bhi paisa aa jayega, that also I will not discount them. So jo bhi aayega 100 crores mera hisab se 2 saal mein aaya na, 2 saal mein aaye to bas hai 100 crores, wo 100 crores bhi discount bhi nahi karte main. So that is the most important. So this is called payback period. Say for example, one example hame de diya hai, project with investment of 1000 rupees and वो उसका लाइफ साइकिल है 5 years, जनरेट्स नेट गेन. नेट गेन इससे पहले मैंने डिस्क्राइब किया, दैट इज अर्निंग माइनस वर्किंग एक्सपेंसेस. सो जो भी आते हैं नेट गेन जितना आया है, फर्स्ट ईयर में 100 रुपीस आए, सेकंड ईयर में 200 आए, आसानी से आपने रिमेंबर करने के वास्ते मैंने दिया. सो 1500 जो पूरा देख लीजिएगा, 1500 नेट गेन माने तो हर एक साल का अर्निंग्स माइनस एक्सपेंडिचर जितना है वो वैसा आ रहा है. सो 1500 आ गया. तो मैं क्या देखता हूँ, फोर इयर्स में दिस प्रोजेक्ट इज गिविंग मी माय इन्वेस्टमेंट. अगर मैनेजमेंट फोर इयर्स में हमारा टोटल अमाउंट 100 200 300 400 ये ऐड कीजिएगा 1000 आ जाएगा. सो 1000 आए तो बस है. कितना साल में आ रहा है? 4 साल में आ रहा है. मेरा क्राइटेरिया 4 साल है, ये प्रोजेक्ट एक्सेप्ट करते हैं. अगर मेरा क्राइटेरिया 2 साल है, ये प्रोजेक्ट रिजेक्ट करते हैं. सो दिस इज हाउ पे बैक पीरियड विल बी यूज्ड. वन एग्जांपल आल्सो आई विल शो. ये प्रोजेक्ट ए, प्रोजेक्ट बी, प्रोजेक्ट सी, ये तीन प्रोजेक्ट्स है. ये तीन प्रोजेक्ट्स मैंने पैसे लगाया 40,000 40,000 40,000 तीनों प्रोजेक्ट में 40,000 समझिएगा. और नेट गेन मैं ये इस्तेमाल करता हूँ. ये नेट गेन व्हेन एवर आई से इट इज अर्निंग माइनस एक्सपेंडिचर. हर एक साल का नेट गेन जो भी है, 8 साल का जितना आते हैं 8 साल का मैंने लिखा है. एंड देन टोटल नेट गेन हर एक प्रोजेक्ट से जितना आ रहे हैं 75,000 49,000 65,000. सो हियर आई सेड the profit will not be looked into. ये payback method में क्या होता है, मेरे पैसे जितना हमारे outflow में लगाया, जो पैसे जितना जल्दी आ जाएगा वो project select हो जाएगा. So with this definition you will understand that the project A is taking 6 years to give me 40,000 and project B is taking 4 years to give me 40,000 and project C it is taking 5 years to give me 40,000. So now you will understand that under payback method project B gets selected because it is giving my money back within 4 years only. So here I already explained that the profits I will not look at. Because if I go by profits, you will understand that project A should be selected. No, I am not interested in that. So this is how the payback period will be selected. Okay. Now, hope you understood payback method, how it will be deployed, and in what circumstances should be deployed. You should understand this. Now, let us go to accounting rate of return. Accounting rate of return or return on investment. इसमें क्या होते हैं, एवरेज प्रॉफिट जो भी एंटायर लाइफ ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट में एवरेज प्रॉफिट कितना होता है, हर एक साल प्रॉफिट होते हैं. सो 10 साल 5 साल जितना भी है एवरेज प्रॉफिट कितना होता है, वो प्रॉफिट में डिवाइडेड बाय दैट हाउ मच मनी वी हैव एम्प्लॉयड ऑन दैट. So that will give rate of return or return on investment. Jitna percentage hai. Hamara management jitna percentage fix ho jayega. Usse jyada aaye to wo project select ho jayega. Nahi to no. So take one small example. Here in this method also, I will not be worried about taking the time value of the money. I will not take into account. Ye time value of the money kya hote hain? I will let you know later. So now a project is there, again 1,000 rupees, and life cycle is 5 years, and a net gain har ek saal ka 100 200 same 1500 aa gaya. Now you see, for this net gain I said average profit hona chahiye. So total net gain kitna hua, 1500, and net gain is 1500 by 5, that is 300 per annum aa jayega. 300 per annum. Now I should get the rate of return on investment. So 300 rate of return. Investment jitna hai 1000 hai, 1000. So how much is the percentage? 30%. So 30%. Agar management 30% lagaye to ye project select ho jayega, nahi to no. Now you please see, I am employing the same accounting rate of return method for the previous example. Now you see. प्रीवियस एग्जाम्पल में प्रोजेक्ट ए, प्रोजेक्ट बी, प्रोजेक्ट सी हमें लिए. पेबैक पीरियड में प्रोजेक्ट बी सेलेक्ट हुआ. अभी देखिए नेट गेन कितना हुआ, 75,000 49,000 एंड 65,000. ये कितना साल का होता, 8 साल का. आठ साल का, हर एक साल का जितना है एवरेज यहाँ पर लगा है, और इन्वेस्टमेंट कितना 40 40 40, तो रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट सॉरी रेट ऑफ रिटर्न, रिटर्न ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट कितना होगा, सो गेन बाय इन्वेस्टमेंट, सो परसेंटेज लगाए तो 23.44 प्रोजेक्ट ए दे रहे एंड प्रोजेक्ट बी 15% दे रहे एंड प्रोजेक्ट सी 20% दे रहे. नाउ इफ द मैनेजमेंट अप्लाइज वॉन्ट्स मी टू गो फॉर अकाउंटिंग रेट ऑफ रिटर्न देन माई प्रायोरिटी विल चेंज. Now the project A will get selected because higher rate of return I am getting, so therefore project A will get that. Now you see, इससे पहले project B payback period में मेरा मन में क्या है, मेरे पैसे आए तो 40,000 आए तो बस है, यहाँ पर क्या हो रहा है, इन्वेस्टमेंट रिटर्न मेरा इन्वेस्टमेंट के ऊपर रिटर्न जितना ज्यादा, कौन सा प्रोजेक्ट ज्यादा देगा that project will get included. Suppose I management decides that more than 20% whatever project gives, those projects should be included. Now I will see project A select ho jayega, project C select ho jayega, project B reject ho jayega. So these are the mathematical tools only. Again I am telling, because maybe 15% ka kam diye to bhi ye to vital project hoga, magar because these are mathematical models, it will not take into consideration all those things. That should be done by the management itself. They should decide, even though it is come, then we should be taken up. Then that is what we employ in the social benefits. By economic advisor, we'll be employing, and then that project will get selected. So this is accounting. Now, these are the orthodox method of doing the things, but here what is happening is jo bhi profits aa rahe hain 8 saal ka 10 saal ka 5 saal ka whatever profits are taking, we are taking them as it is. 10 saal ke baad 75,000 aaye to bhi we are taking that 75,000 as it is, but in fact 75,000 which you receive in 10th year, अगर आपने डिस्काउंट करे तो अभी ये साल के रेट से अभी करे तो वो बहुत कम होते हैं. 75,000 विच यू विल बी गेटिंग आफ्टर 10 ईयर्स, इट इज नॉट 75,000, इट विल बी मच मच लेस. दैट इज वाई it is called discounting cash flow. So this cash discounting cash flow technique mein kya hote hain hame dekhe hain. So discounted cash flow technique take into account the time value of the money. Ye time value of the money kya hote hain, just like I said, 5 saal ke upar nahi to 10 years afterwards whatever we will get, it is not the same. If we receive it today, 75,000, 10 saal ke baad aaye to, that is not equal to 75,000 now. So in other words, the value of the money gets depreciated over the years, hence the concept of discounted cash flow. Aapne suna hoga compounding interest, aapko pata hai, agar आपके पास ज्यादा पैसे है, नॉर्मली यू विल गिव फॉर लेंडिंग एट रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट, सो दैट रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट यू विल बी कैलकुलेटिंग 10% 5% व्हाटएवर यू लाइक, सो यू विल बी कंपाउंडिंग देम एंड देन फ्रॉम द पर्सन यू विल बी कलेक्टिंग द मनी. सो दैट कंपाउंडिंग इंटरेस्ट फैक्टर इट विल बी इंक्रीजिंग, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड कंपाउंडिंग फैक्टर. अगर वो इनवर्स करे तो then it is called discounting factor. That means 75,000 which you will be getting at 10 years afterwards, it will not be the same how much it should be. So you should not compound it, you should discount that 75,000 for 10 years. Say for example, if you want 10%, so at 10%, 10 years afterwards you are getting now how much it will be. If you deduct it, then it will be around 60,000 or 50,000. So this is how we should look at the discounted cash flow technique. So here, not only money, whatever I am getting, I am taking into account, but not at the same value. I'll be taking at much discounted, much lesser value. I am equating and then getting the discounted amount only I'll be taking. Now, a discounted amount lene ke time pe bhi thoda change aaye. We should keep in mind that I am talking about the future receipts. Future receipts. Jo bhi future receipts mein aa jayega, wo to discount karna chahiye. Remember this. At the same time, हमारा रेलवे में आप देखे होगा, हमारा प्रोजेक्ट्स 2 साल 3 साल 5 साल वैसे चलते हैं. सो द प्रोजेक्ट वॉट एवर सपोज 4 साल लगे हैं. नाउ वी आर वेरी स्पीडली वी आर एग्जीक्यूटिंग अवर प्रोजेक्ट. सपोज 4 साल में इफ सम मनी वी हैव स्पेंट, दैट इज आउटफ्लो में है, बिकॉज वी हैव स्पेंट, इट इज आउटफ्लो. So outflow 4 साल पहले करे तो suppose 10,000 rupees you have invested. It is not 10,000. It will be much more. Now it will be much more because so such items you have to compound them. Thus 4 साल पहले जो भी आपने खर्च किया है that 10,000 it is not 10,000. You have to compound it. So कब कहां पर इक्वेट करना ये दोनों, जो भी एक प्रोजेक्ट कहां पूरा हो जाएगा और कहां से जिस साल से ये पैसे कमाने शुरू करते हैं, दैट ईयर वी कॉल इट एज जीरो ईयर. सो दैट जीरो ईयर देयर आई विल बी इक्वेटिंग द फ्यूचर इनफ्लो एंड earlier outflow. दोनों ये तो earlier का outflow हमें compound करते हैं ये साल तक और future का outflow inflow है वो discount करके ये zero value zero year के time पे दोनों बराबर देखते हैं. ये कहाँ zero हो रहे हैं वो trial and error से देखते हैं. और एक तरीका एक होते हैं, जो भी ये हमारे जो खर्च किए वो कम है और जो इनफ्लो है ये जीरो ईयर में ज्यादा है, दैट इज कॉल्ड दीज आर कॉल्ड पीवीस. पीवी माने प्रेजेंट वैल्यूज. ये प्रेजेंट वैल्यूज जो भी कंपाउंड करके पहले पिछले साल में खर्च किए सो कंपाउंड करके और अगले साल में जो भी आ रहे हैं वो डिस्काउंट करके ये जीरो ईयर के रूप में प्रेजेंट वैल्यू लाए तो अगर वो पॉजिटिव है, पॉजिटिव माने हमारा अर्निंग्स ज्यादा है और खर्च कम है, देन इट इज कॉल्ड इट इज गेनफुल. दैट इज कॉल्ड नेट प्रेजेंट वैल्यू. नाउ आई एम टेकिंग यू टू द डिस्काउंटेड कैश फ्लो फर्स्ट method. It is net present value method. A net present value method mein kya hota hai? We'll see that again. I'll let you know. Now, what is this discounted factor? Kaisa aata hai? Aur ek sujhav, aur ek example aapko batana chahte hain. Agar 100 rupees, if you want. At the end of 5 years, 5 साल के बाद आप 100 rupees आपको होना चाहिए तो at the rate of 10% interest you should invest now 62 rupees. If you invest 62 rupees now at the rate of suppose you are employing in a particular bank or if you are giving to a lender and if you are expecting 10%. And you are bound to get 100 rupees after 5 years. That means if you want to get 100 rupees after 5 years and gaining 10% interest, you have to invest now 62 rupees. So ये 62 rupees compound होके आपको 100 rupees हो जाएगा 5 साल के बाद. So what I want to say is that compounding factor को inverse करे तो you will get discounted factors. You may be surprised, sir, ये discounted factors कहाँ पर मिलेगा? ये तो compound factor आपको आसानी से आ जाएगा 10%, 100 rupees, 110 rupees होता है. और दूसरे साल में 121 रुपीज होते हैं. तो ये तो मैथमेटिकली कंपोनेंट फैक्टर, वो इन्वर्स करे वन बाई करे तो ये तो डिस्काउंटेड फैक्टर होते हैं. सो जो भी डिस्काउंटेड फैक्टर 100 रुपीज फर्स्ट साल में आ रहे इट विल बी 90 रुपीज. फर्स्ट साल के बाद 100 रुपीज व्हाट यू इफ यू वांट टू हैव 100 रुपीज नेक्स्ट ईयर एट द रेट ऑफ 10% यू शुड इन्वेस्ट 90 रुपीज. Similarly, for the 100 rupees, if you are in 2 years, if you want, then you should invest 82 rupees. And if you want 100 rupees, then 68 rupees you have to invest. And if you want 100 rupees after 5 years, you should invest 62 rupees. But this is assuming that it is 10% return you are getting. So this a tarike ka 100 rupees which I am going to get later on, I am discounting it at the required rate, and how much I will be getting that, this is called PV, present value. 100 rupees ka ek saal ke baad aaye to 90 rupees, do saal ke baad aaye to 82 rupees. So 100 rupees if I am getting after 5 years. If I equate it, present value 100 rupees of 5 years afterwards. If I am getting now itself, I will be taking only at the face value. It is 62 rupees only. This we call it as a discounted cash flow. Now in that, so after understanding this discounted cash flow, now as I said in NPV method, this is the first method after DCF. In the NPV method, what I will be doing is a 0 year I will be taking. As I said, our project always it will be started earlier, and after 2 years or 3 years it will be completed, and in that year it starts earning. So that year in which the project starts earning, we call it as a 0 year. So there in that year, what earlier we have computed, what we have expended, that it will be compounded, and whatever in future, whatever we are going to get, if I am discounting, then if that is more than whatever discounted present value is more than what I have invested, then it is worth investing. मैंने 10,000 रुपीज हमें इन्वेस्ट किया, एंड आई एम गेटिंग डिस्काउंटेड आफ्टर डिस्काउंटिंग इफ आई एम गेटिंग 11,000, देन इट इज गेन. सो दिस इज हाउ आई विल बी टेकिंग अप दिस डिस्काउंटेड कैश फ्लो एनपीवी मेथड. सो प्रोजेक्ट हमें जितना खर्च किए वो रिटर्न, वो प्रोजेक्ट से रिटर्न जो भी आएगा 5 साल, 10 साल, 30 साल, जितना साल है वो साल में हमारे को जितना भी आएगा, दैट अमाउंट आई विल बी, इफ इट इज मोर देन द इन्वेस्टमेंट देन इट इज ए वर्थ इन्वेस्टिंग, अदरवाइज इट विल बी रिजेक्टेड. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एनपीवी मेथड. बट ओनली इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट हियर इन एनपीवी मेथड, व्हाई रेलवे इज नॉट यूजिंग, इवन दो इट इज a discounted cash flow method, because हमारा project में जो भी हमें खर्च कर रहे, outflow कर रहे 3 साल से पहले, 2 साल से पहले, और ये साल में भी जितना हमें खर्च कर रहे हैं वो compound कर रहे 0 year को लाया, और वो project हमारे को 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, whatever it is we are getting that I have discounted and then brought to 0 year at the rate fixed by the management. That is most important. At the rate of return fixed by the management. So management हमारे को बोलेगा all the projects you work out at 10% or 15% or 20%. Then accordingly we will be working out, and then whatever project that is more than the cutoff return. अगर 10% है, 10% जो भी ज्यादा है वो सेलेक्ट हो जाएगा. सो 10% के रूप में हमें एनपीवी प्रोजेक्ट का खर्च और प्रोजेक्ट का अर्निंग दोनों को मिला के अगर अर्निंग दैट इज इनफ्लो ज्यादा है, डिस्काउंटेड करने के बाद इनफ्लो ज्यादा है तो वो सेलेक्ट हो जाएगा. But why we are not employing, even though it is a time value of money I have taken, and whatever I have spent earlier, I have compounded, and whatever afterwards I am receiving, all of them I have discounted to 0 year, and my NPV, that is jo bhi kharch kiya hai, outflow hai, aur jo bhi inflow hai, inflow minus outflow, it is positive mane to it is beneficial, and that beneficial also it is at the management set rate only it is beneficial, then I should employ this. But railway will not employ this NPV because it is telling that this particular project is financially viable at the given rate of return by management. It will not tell what is the potential of the project. ये project में ताकत कितना है. It is only 10%. Or will it give me 20%? Or will it give me 30%? That is not told as per the NPV. So that is why even though net present value, it will tell only the earlier outflows are much lesser than the inflows or future inflows at the present level. So NPV, that is net present value, it is positive, hence selected. Present value at what rate you are calculating? At the return fixed by management. 10%, 10%, 15%, 15%. अगर मगर ये प्रोजेक्ट में जितना ताकत है वो पता नहीं चलेगा. सो फॉर दैट आई विल बी यूजिंग IRR मेथड, इंटरनल रेट ऑफ रिटर्न मेथड अंडर DCF टेक्निक. सो आई विल आल्सो डिस्कस दिस DCF टेक्निक IRR मेथड. नाउ सी प्लीज सी दिस NPV मेथड. स्मॉल एग्जांपल, 1000 रुपीस हमें एम्प्लॉय किया 5 years में और नेट गेन. Now I am not using the net gain because this is what I am using is cash flow technique. So that is why I use the word net cash flow. Profit is nahi mante main. So net cash flow. Net cash flow mane earning kya hai? So net cash flow 500-400 aisa aa raha hai. So this is 1500. But these 1500 earlier I took 1500 only. But now I cannot take because the time value of money I have to take. So what I will be doing is, because management asked me to arrive at 10%. So discounted factor, already we have seen 90, 82, 75, 68, 62. So same percentage I will apply for the net cash flow. So thereby, if you get that present value, how much it is coming? 1208.95 rupees. Now, this is present value of the future inflows. Please remember, this is the present value of future inflows. So now 1250. So that means 1500, which I will be getting over the years for 5 years. It is not 1500. It is only 1208 rupees at the rate of 10%. Now, jitna kitna hota hai? It is 1280 minus 1000 rupees which I have employed. It is 208 rupees 90 paise. It is more. It is positive. Hence, it is selected. So this is how it will be done. And one example also, I'll see. Sorry. One example we'll see. So this is management asked me to take up, to work out NPV at 15% for project A and project B. So project A is 20,000. Project B also investment is 20,000. But there are different cash flows I am getting. In the project A, I am getting 45,000. And cash flows for the project B, I'm getting 53,000. Now what I will be doing, this is the year, initial year is 20,000 only. So 20,000, I will not disturb it, but the discounted cash flow for other future inflows, what net gain is there, I have to employ discounted factor at what rate? 15%. A pure ke pure factors ka tables hai, हमारा रेलवे फाइनेंस कोड सेकंड चैप्टर एज अपेंडिक्स देयर दिस टेबल्स आर देयर फ्रॉम देयर यू कैन टेक सो दिस टेबल्स विल दैट इज 5500 रुपीस इनटू 0.870 इफ यू पुट दैट इज आफ्टर 1 ईयर इट विल बी ओनली 4785 सो लाइक दिस यू विल बी डिस्काउंटिंग नाउ द एनपीवी इज 5923 एट 15% Now project B, if you work out the net NPV, it is 10,873. So which project will get selected? The project which is giving more NPV at same percentage, because it is same percentage, more NPV project B is getting and project B will be getting selected. But as I said, there is inherent flaw in this method, NPV method, because it is telling only at this percentage project B is yielding more money, that is fine, but how much potential is there? For that I will be employing internal rate of return method, which is used in our railway project justifications, capital investments, wherever we do, we will be doing this. So what is this internal rate of return? A rate at which the present value of the cash inflow money, earnings, with the present value of the outflow money, expenditure. Is a project ke upar hame jitna bhi kharch kiya hai, what is the present value now, and whatever inflows are there, future inflows, wo 0 year mein jitna ho jayega, ye dono हमें तुलन करते हैं जीरो ईयर में. नाउ दिस तुलन करना, हाउ इट विल बी डन? इट इज नाउ इन दिस मेथड नथिंग विल बी गिवन, नो रेट ऑफ रिटर्न विल बी गिवन एट दिस रेट ओनली यू डू कैलकुलेशन. नो, वी शुड नो द पोटेंशियल ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट. सो टू नो द पोटेंशियल ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट हमें क्या करते हैं, ये ट्रायल एंड एरर मेथड में हमें इंटरनल रेट ऑफ रिटर्न करते हैं. हाउ दिस ट्रायल एंड एरर विल बी डन? बिकॉज इन द एनपीवी द मैनेजमेंट हैज गिवन 15%, सो वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड, बट नाउ हियर इट इज नॉट दैट. सो बट व्हाट आई एम टेलिंग इज दिस आल्सो ए डीसीएफ मेथड ओनली. Here the important point is rate of return, how much potential is there in the project, I'll be working out in by way of trial and error method how I'll be doing. You please see this. If any IRR higher than or equal to the required rate of return, that is hurdle rate, we call it as a hurdle rate or cost of capital. Hamare ko capital jitna time jitna कास्ट में आ रहे हैं उससे ज्यादा जितना हमारे को होना चाहिए, दैट मैनेजमेंट विल टेल, एंड देन द प्रोजेक्ट इज कंसिडर्ड फाइनेंशियली वायबल. ऑल ऑफ यू अवेयर दैट एज ऑफ नाउ अंडर डीसीएफ टेक्निक आईआरआर मेथड, एनी प्रोजेक्ट टू बी डिक्लेयर्ड एज फाइनेंशियली वायबल इट इज 10%. जो भी प्रोजेक्ट 10% के ऊपर आईआरआर मेथड में ज्यादा आए तो देन वी विल बी क्लियरिंग देम एज डीसीएफ. अंडर डीसीएफ मेथड इट इज आईआरआर मेथड, इट इज फाइनेंशियली वायबल. दैट्स ऑल. with our well bottom comment, it will go to railway board individual directors. They will see and how much money is available and whichever project is giving higher rate of return, that they will select it. Because ये bag में बहुत ज्यादा है ये हमारा works program में. So कौन सा work को उन लोग select करना. So they go by whichever project is giving higher internal rate of return. Cut off return कितना है, hurdle rate 10%. अगर एक project 21% दे रहे, 21% get selected, वो priority हो जाएगा. अगर 30% किसी ने project दे रहे and that will be selected. So this is how the selection of the projects for inclusion in the pink book will be done by doing this IRR financial justification under DCF technique, IRR method. So एक example of ध्यान से सुनिएगा. इसमें ये तो zero year माने तो ये तो complete हो चुके हैं, that is one I have given. And इससे पहले ये साल में 20,000 I have employed and इससे पहले 10,000 I have employed. So compounding factor because outflow, that is why minus I put. So 1.10 at 10% and another 10,000 I have employed in second year. So that is 1,000, that is 10% second year का compound करे तो 1.21 हो जाएगा. तो उसका present values कितना है. So वो project present values हमें ला चुके हैं minus 10,000 in the second year. In the पिछले दो साल में हमें लगे हैं. अभी present value 12,100 रुपीस हो जाएगा. So this is how I'll be doing. And future flows हम मैंने क्या किया, easy होने के कारण 1 to 7 years का 10,000 uniform. Normally uniform it will not be there, but in our finance code there will be uniform series बोल के भी tables होते हैं. So that uniform series you see, and 10% it will be cumulative and it will be 4.8.68. So 10,000 a present value कितना होता, it will be 48,680 rupees होते हैं. So 48,000 and a present value, other present values outflows if you remove, then the net present value will be 5,580 at the rate of 10%. Now this how long, because trial and error I told, so 5,000 it has come. Now this NPV again you have to work out again 5% margin lijiyega and again you will work out. And now this positive NPV, it has turned into negative NPV. Now by this you will understand that the under IRR method the return of which can be yielded by this project, it lies between 10% and 15%. Listen very carefully. This project will yield, because at 10% it is positive NPV is there and at 15% it is negative NPV is there. Now you will understand that it should be between 10% and 15%. Now as a financial officer, you cannot say that it lies between 10% to 15%. Now you have to work out what is the exact rate of return. So that exact rate of return, it will be worked out by employing interpolation method. Interpolation method. ये interpolation method में क्या होते हैं, just see, listen very carefully. ये कहां पर recent NPV positive है, that percentage you take 10. So 10 here, 5,580 is NPV positive. So at what rate? 10%. So that 10 less what you have to suppose to do is the NPV of at that particular rate, that is 5,580 divided by the difference of the NPVs where the positive turned into negative. A positive 5,580 turned into negative 3,120 at 15%. So ये वो दोनों का difference क्या होते हैं? That the difference of, I mean माने तो minus of minus plus हो जाएगा, into what is the difference between the two interests? it is 5%. So 5, if you do it, it will come 0.321. So 10 plus 0.321, it is 10.321%. That means this project is financially viable. In our railway terms, if you want to say this project, it will yield at 10.321% yield will be there. So now you will understand, if it is only positive, that is NPV method, I will suppose at 10% you take, that means this project, it will be yielding 5,580. So it is positive. So therefore select it. We know that it is only 10%, a 10% yield, but uska potential kitna hai? It is 10.321%. That is the importance of this internal rate of return method. So having said this, all internal rate of return or DCF technique methods, all methods I have employed. Now let us go to our railway project appraisal. Kaisa ho jayega? Ye loop line mein, line capacity works mein, kya kya hume dekhna chahiye? That we will be seeing that. So a railway project appraisal kaisa hote hai? One important point is, any proposal if you are receiving, you should get financial justification. Financial justification mane to ek brief noting aana chahiye, and that should be scrutinized by our accounts office. Even though where date of return is not there, that means where financial justification is not required, even then also, as a man of ordinary prudence, kaisa dekhte hain waisa hi hame dekhna chahiye. That is one. Second, net gain and IRR. So no proposal will be included in the pink book unless we get a rate of return under internal rate of return of 10% under DCF technique method on the initial estimated cost. Ye saal mein hame estimate ki abstract estimate kiya, wo cost mein 10% IRR method se aa rahe hain iske jyada, so that we can say financially justified. Then, as I already said, depreciation interest will not be reckoned. Then, this is most important for our 3A examination. What are the points you will look into when line capacity work proposal has come to accounts department? So please, a 5 minute thoda dhyan se sun lijiyega. Line capacity works means the capacity of the line is increasing. Capacity means what is the chartered capacity of the line. That means kitna pair of trains jana hai. Suppose 10k waste wo hai, that is maximum capacity. Isse jyada aap trains ko bhejna hai, then you have to increase the line capacity. So waisa ja kya kya hai? Gauge conversion, doubling, isse pehle bhi main bol chuke hain, major signaling schemes, lengthening or provisioning of the loops, crossing stations. Ye pura agar crossing station hai, crossing station mein kuch log build karna hai aur kuch log maintain karne ke waste wo repair and maintenance ke waste hame kuch logon ko recruit karna hai, so that also we should take into account. Okay, so costing 50 lakhs or more, detailed survey should be conducted by commercial department people and accounts department. Without that, no line capacity work should be taken up. That is one important point which we have to write. One more important point is, a thorough techno-economical appraisal should be made in respect of each of these sections proposed to take up for change of traction. Normally, foot-by-foot survey karte hain, diesel se electrification jana hai, so techno-economic appraisal is must. Then, agar ek line capacity work hume le chuke hain, le rahe hain, wo line capacity work lene ke time pe, aur pure section mein कहाँ कहाँ ये चेंजेस भी और एडिशनल वर्क्स करना पड़ता है तो यू शुड नॉट लीव। अगर एक लैंड कैपेसिटी वर्क आपने प्रपोज किया, इट हैज बीन रिसीव्ड एंड यू शुड सी दैट बिकॉज ऑफ दिस लैंड कैपेसिटी वर्क, अगर दूसरे जगह पे जो जो वर्क टेकअप करना है वो वर्क्स का एक्सपेंडिचर भी हमें कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट में शामिल करना चाहिए, दैट इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट। सो जो भी एडिशनल वर्क्स बिकॉज ऑफ द लैंड कैपेसिटी वर्क विच वी आर एग्जामिनिंग, इफ एनी वेयर इट हैज टू बी डन, देन दैट एक्सपेंडिचर ऑल्सो वी हैव टू टेक। देन जो भी एडिशनल ट्रैफिक के ऊपर हमें ये जस्टिफाई कर रहे हैं लैंड कैपेसिटी वर्क, इट शुड बी बियॉन्ड द एग्जिस्टिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ द सेक्शन। वो सेक्शन डिजाइन करना है 11 पेयर ऑफ ट्रेंस को डिजाइन किया है, अगर एडिशनल ट्रैफिक के वास्ते आपने प्रपोज किया तो देन यू शुड बी मोर देन 11 ट्रेंस यू शुड कैरी। Suppose even after doing a loop, if you are getting only 11 chartered capacity, then you cannot call it as a financially justified. So that is one important. And one more point is that normally, please listen carefully. Normally, the people will be tempting you to giving that ye work karne ke time pe karne ke baad हमारे को डिटेंशन कम हो जाएगा, ये डिटेंशन कम होने के बाद हमारा अर्निंग कैपेसिटी बहुत ज्यादा हो जाएगा, तो दिस इज दी अर्निंग विच आई एम गेटिंग। नेवर फॉल इनटू द ट्रैप। एनी लाइन कैपेसिटी वर्क इट शुड नॉट बी जस्टिफाइड ओनली ऑन द अर्निंग कैपेसिटी दैट इज गोइंग टू बी इंक्रीज। दे हैव टू टेल यू दैट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ द इंक्रीज इन लोकोमोटिव और वैगन। ये वैगन और लोकोमोटिव का कैसा यूटिलाइजेशन ज्यादा हो जाएगा वैसा जस्टिफाई करना, बट नॉट ऑन द अर्निंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ द स्टॉक सेव्ड। प्लीज लिसन दिस वेरी केयरफुली। एंड वन मोर पॉइंट इज दैट एंड ए न्यू टाइप ऑफ नॉर्मली हमारा रोलिंग स्टॉक का जो भी प्रपोजल आते हैं वो एडिशनल कैपेसिटी का सेपरेटली इन द बजट वी विल बी प्रपोजिंग बेस्ड ऑन द ट्रैफिक प्रोजेक्शन। But so for that financial justification is not required. But what I want to say is, agar naye type of rolling stock propose kar rahe hain to be acquired or to be manufactured, just like our Tejas or Vande Bharat Express, then financial justification should be made on the proposed investment to see that it yields the requisite financial return. Otherwise, no. Then. ग्रुप जस्टिफिकेशन प्रोजेक्ट एज ए होल जो भी अलग अलग का वर्क होते हैं वो अलग अलग वर्क इट कैन नॉट बी जस्टिफाइड इन दैट केस ग्रुप जस्टिफिकेशन इज परमिटेड। दो तीन तरीके का करके आप ग्रुप जस्टिफिकेशन के रूप में प्रपोजल रेलवे प्रोजेक्ट प्रपोजल कर सकते हैं। एंड सेविंग ऑन ए particular railway should not be taken up into account if it is a loss to another railway, because it is not a gain to us. That is how we should think. And expenditure, especially average annual cost of service, har ek saal inflow outflow hote hain na, so expenditure hote hain, so that expenditure you should take average annual cost of operation, average annual cost of maintenance and repair of the assets. Jitna saal hai wo एवरेज करके एवरेज एसेट खर्च करने का एवरेज एनुअल कॉस्ट ऑफ सर्विस वी शुड अराइव एट। देन अर्निंग्स आल्सो शुड बी वर्कड आउट फॉर ईच ऑफ द कमोडिटी एंड लीड फ्रॉम इट्स ऑरिजिन अप टू द टर्मिनेशन ऑफ द ट्रैफिक, नॉट ओनली टू ए पर्टिकुलर सेक्शन, एंटायर टर्मिनेशन यू शुड टेक द अर्निंग्स हाउ मच इट इज गोइंग टू यील्ड। एंड वन मोर इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, प्लीज लिसन दिस केयरफुली, एस्पेशली स्टेशन to station rates, or not only that, any project which you want to include in the pink book, whenever small increases in the traffic in the short run if you want to improve, better use marginal costing benefit. That means long-term variable you should use. This long-term variable cost, jitna we should take, it is given in the finance code volume one as a percentage. So total cost and that percentage if you adopt, and to that extent our expenditure will come down. Otherwise, if you take full expenditure, that is called fully distributed cost. If you take fully distributed cost, then the project will never come to light. It will never yield the rate of return. It will be negative. So therefore, always use incremental cost wherever any small increase in traffic is there, or over the short run, if you want to justify the project, it is permitted and it is available. Fully distributed cost, you will be arriving, and long-term variable cost, you will be applying by the percentages given in the finance code. So this is the important point which you will be taking up. And one more point which I would like to add is sensitivity analysis. Normally in railway, it is not done, but sometimes as a finance officer, as earlier I told, even though as a percentage in return IRR, everything it is not there, accounts officer should see as a man of ordinary prudence. So this sensitivity analysis is, suppose a particular project is there at 100 rupees, a project is there. In that, what is the vital part? Vital part money, what is the highest cost material that is available? That highest cost of the material, if it is varied, that is, say by 5% it is varied, then what will be the internal rate of return? Again, you can ask the executive to work out. And if by doing that sensitivity analysis, you can write in our financial verbatim comments, you can tell by this is the vital part. And if that rate, it slightly varies from 5% or 10%, the project will turn to red. That also we can make a point. So that railway board will take a call. So that analysis is called sensitivity analysis. How? That means for a particular variable, all other things remain same. For a particular variable, what is the sensitivity? Is it still financially viable or not? So that will be seen here. So this is sensitivity analysis. And one more last point, which I want to say, it is post-project appraisal. Project ho chuke hai, big book mein aaya, hume kharch kiya, and it has been handed over to open line. Now, we should learn lessons from that. How much we have estimated originally, how much we are getting, that is called productivity test. So that productivity test, it should be carried out. It is a meaningful way and realistic way it should be carried out. And whether our estimation, which we have done at the project estimate stage, whether it is yielding the same or not. So it will be a serving lesson for the future. Having said this, I will be concluding, giving you, even though I told very abstract way, suppose in a project proposal, what are the elements that are available? What are the items to be seen? I told you. What are the elements that will be available in a loop line? Suppose provision of loop line. What are the elements that will be there? Just a cursory glance, we will see, and then we will wind up the session. One is finance justification is required. Another one is cost of the project, including rolling stock that is required, whether you purchase it or not. But you should require that rolling stock cost. And then year-wise funding. Jitna har ek saal mein, jitna funds ho, aapko hona chahiye. In how many years you want to complete it. That is most important. Then additional earnings, jitna ye project yield karte hain, per annum, that is required. And then additional requirement of rolling stock, already I told you. Then cost of the movement of additional traffic, वो ट्रैफिक ट्रांसपोर्ट करने में आपको एवरेज एनुअल कॉस्ट ऑफ सर्विस जितना आते हैं, क्या इसमें एवरेज एनुअल कॉस्ट ऑफ सर्विस में क्या क्या लेते हैं? लाइन हॉल कॉस्ट, कॉस्ट ऑफ ऑपरेशन एंड मेंटेनेंस, कॉस्ट ऑफ डॉक्यूमेंटेशन एंड टर्मिनल सर्विसेज, ये पूरे हमारा एवरेज एनुअल कॉस्ट में लेते हैं। सो ये तो एनुअल कॉस्ट आ जाएगा और एडिशनल अर्निंग्स आएगा हर एक आनम का, हर एक साल का। नाउ व्हाट इज द नेट अर्निंग, नेट इनफ्लो क्या है? दैट आल्सो यू विल बी गेटिंग एडिशनल अर्निंग्स इनफ्लो एंड आउटफ्लो इज देयर, प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट इंक्लूडिंग रोलिंग स्टॉक और एवरेज एनुअल कॉस्ट, दोनों हमें ले चुके हैं। और नेट अर्निंग्स दैट मीन्स नेट इनफ्लो, मोस्टली नेट इनफ्लो ओनली इट विल बी देयर, अगर आउटफ्लो है तो रिजेक्ट कर सकते हैं। इनफ्लो हाउ मच इज नेट अर्निंग, सो दिस इज हाउ वी विल बी सीइंग। नॉट ओनली दैट, वन मोर इनफ्लो विल बी देयर, इट इज द रेसिडुअल वैल्यू ऑफ द एसेट। व्हाट इज मेंट बाय दिस रेसिडुअल वैल्यू ऑफ द एसेट? नॉर्मली बिकॉज एज आई सेड इट इज ए मैथमेटिकल टूल, फॉर 30 इयर्स इफ यू टेक the discounted cash flows at the end of the 30 year, financially that project is null and void. The financially that project will not be there, all the values will become zero. So at the end of the 30th year, what is this always value from that project? That will be again inflow. So inflow means it is not only this is only 30th year you will be getting, and every year net earnings inflow and outflow will be there, average annual cost of service, and one outflow will be there, a project cost including rolling stock. So these are all the things which essentially will be there in the any project which will be coming for financial verification. So with this I conclude my session and I am open for the questions.
Participants, please raise your hand for any queries. Mr. Ajay Singh, please unmute.
Sir, namaste. Sir, financial analysis or economic evaluation, kya hai? Difference?
A financial evaluation, it will be done at zonal railway level, and that project, it will be sent to railway board. Through our works program, that is called financial evaluation. But as I said, being railways being a government organization, it has a responsibility to see that certain weaker areas, sections, or the areas which are not progressing well to be progressed. So therefore, as a maybe as a financial angle, from the financial angle, it may not yield the required IRR of 10%. But if the government decides, because railway being a government department, if government decides that that particular project should be taken up, then that will be sent to economic directorate. A railway board may cut them. So economic evaluation, there is a separate annexure is there in the our finance code also, but don't bother now. But if that project is required to be seen, agar GDP ke GDP ko a project help karega, nahi to weaker section ka weak help karega, nahi to backward area ka help karega, so then in that case the economic evaluator, that is economic advisor to railway board, will be there in the railway board. So economic evaluation, it will be done in the railway board. So let us not bother much about that. But what I want to say is that you will be surprised, but in pink book, some projects which are yielding minus return also will be there. So you should not get surprised, because it is done on the social benefit analysis. For the upliftment of the backward areas, it is being included. So that we will come to know. So finance angle is a must for all. Financial justification is a must for all the projects which are sent to Railway Board through FWP. But final selection on social considerations, if it is to be done, it will be examined by economic advisor to Railway Board. It is not in the realm of zonal railway. Economic evaluation is not in the realm of zonal railway. It is with Railway Board.
Yeah. Sir, there is a chart message. What is line haul cost?
Yeah, line haul cost already I explained. Line haul cost. Okay. There is a particular performance. Sorry. There are 4 or 5 points which I have written. One sec. So those are all the things which we have to take while calculating the line haul cost. Line haul cost mein per 1000 GTKM kitna kharch hote hain, and then how much total GTKM hamare ko a project mein haul karne ke waste jitna GTKM hame estimate kar rahe, then that per 1000 GTKM how much cost is coming, and total GTKM multiply kare to that will be the line haul cost hota hai. That means to carry that particular additional traffic, how much expenditure we are going to incur, so that will be the line haul cost. Iske alawa average annual cost mein cost of operation and maintenance, cost of documentation and terminal services, these are also will be taken.
So in financial justification, what is RSP item? Someone is
basically. In financial justification, it is capital investment. Capital investment, as I somewhere I mentioned, as per traffic plan, future traffic में जितना traffic हमें haul करते हैं, उसके वास्ते जितना locos होना, जितना how many coaches होना, how many wagons hona, that will be justified and processed. That is entirely different. But whenever some additional items which are required to be justified on cost as cum condition basis, then in that case we will be taking up that RSP projects with financial justification.
Yeah, next Mr. Ajay Singh, please unmute. Ajay Singh, please unmute.
Hello sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, आपने जितनी भी टेक्निक बताया उसमें जो रेट ऑफ रिटर्न है ये अप्रोक्सीमेट नॉट एक्चुअल, एक्चुअल नहीं है. तो फ्यूचर प्रोजेक्ट मैंने मतलब अकाउंट फाइनेंस ने वेट किया, उसके बाद कोई फाइनेंस के द्वारा जो रिटर्न एक्चुअल जो है लेस आता है, तो उसके लिए क्या किया जाए, उसके लिए अमेंडमेंट क्या करें?
Thank you. Very good question. It is only a lesson. It is only a lesson which the railway learned.
Yes.
क्योंकि हमें financial initial में हमें जो भी project हमें estimate verify करके project abstract estimate वो works program में शामिल करने के time पे हमें DCF technique use करके इन आवर वर्बैटम कमेंट पीएफए का वर्बैटम कमेंट्स में हम लिखते हैं दिस इज फाइनेंशियली वायबल, इट इज यील्डिंग अंडर डीसीएफ टेक्निक, अंडर एज पर आईआरआर इट इज यील्डिंग 21% हम लिखते हैं. बट एज यू सेड इट इज ओनली ऑन इनिशियल कॉस्ट. अगर एक्चुअल प्रोजेक्ट एग्जीक्यूशन में दैट विल नॉट बी सेम. In we saw in many cases 200% 300% bhi zyada ho chuke hain. That is different issue. But yes, bahut zyada kharch kiya hoga. Even then, suppose that item if it is selected for post-project appraisal. Post-project appraisal will throw light of the deficiencies in our financial scrutiny, not only in our financial scrutiny, in the project preparation itself. What are the problems? Why so much variation has come? And when actually that project is handover to open line, how much returns we are getting it? Under productivity test, if you do, then you will know the fault where it lies. Is it in our survey estimates? Is it in our socio-economic survey? Or is it in our techno-economic survey? Or is it in our average annual expenditure estimation? Where that fault lies? And we should see that as a learning lesson for Rangi, and nothing can be done. We knew, I won't tell the project names, but there are umpteen number of projects which were taken up on social considerations, and then they are giving lesser returns. Not only at estimated stage, some lesser return we may have estimated, but more than that, losses we are incurring. So we cannot abandon them because already it was sunk. That is why our capital investment always, it is a very, very carefully it should be done. But once it is sunk, there is no issue. Only thing is how to come out of that. That is why we'll be doing that uneconomical branch lines. So some area, some items will be selected, and then some sections will be weeding out. Some will be closing down in consultation with state governments. So many other things we are doing. But as you said, whatever actually, if it is turned, our tables are turned from 21%, if it is coming to 8% or minus 8%, then we can't do anything. So just learn lessons, that's all.
Any more queries? How can do test of remunerativeness? One message from Yadav.
Okay. What, Nashakar, again repeat.
Sir, how can do test of remunerativeness?
Test of remunerativeness. Yeah, that is project appraisal. Just like in one slide, I clearly told that whatever way details when a project is proposed, how we are doing, similar way, similar information, we should adopt and then work out the test of remunerativeness. That means, again, DCF technique and IRR method we have to employ, and then how much rate of return it is yielding. That means whatever problems, whatever we collected at the time of initially when proposing, same information, now what is available, at what cost it was completed, and what are the earnings which earlier we have done, and what are the earnings which we are getting, what is the annual average cost which we have selected, and now what is the average annual cost. Similar parameters we have to apply and then work out test of remunerativeness and then compare it. Yeah.
Any more queries? Yeah, there are no queries, sir.
Thank you, Naisra Garu.
What is the difference between ARR and IRR? Someone messaged.
Yeah. ARR, accounting rate of return, means how much we are getting. It is orthodox method, first one. And it is the return, how much we are getting on the investment. That is average profit we'll be taking, divided by what is the amount which we have employed. That will give you ARR. Whereas IRR is the method getting the IRR is trial and error method. And by employing DCF technique, we'll be getting that. One is discounted cash flow method technique, and the earlier one, it is a traditional method or orthodox method where time value of the money is not taken into consideration.
So, no more queries from the panelists or from the participants.
Okay.
That was an exhaustive and informative session, sir. On behalf of the Academy, I thank all the participants. I also thank the speaker of the day, Shri K. Damodar Prasad Garu. Thank you, sir. Thank you, one and all. Just to remind, tomorrow's session will be on work resistance and completion report. Login at 14:45 hours. Session will start at 15 hours. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, Sitara,
for giving me this opportunity. Thank you, sir. Thanks, sir. And all the best.
We are really privileged, sir. Thank you.